Good afternoon. So in yesterday's lecture we have seen the absolute loader and bootstrap loader. So what is basically the loader? Loader means a source program is converted to object program by assemblers and compilers. So the loader is a program which accepts the object code and prepare them for the execution and initiates execution. So the functions of these loader allocating, linking and adjust all the address dependent location, that is relocation and loading. So the next type of loader is relocating. So the loaders that allow for the program relocation are called relocating loaders or the relative loaders. The concept of relocation is that the execution of the object program is done using any part of available and sufficient memory, and the object program is loaded into memory whenever there is room for it. The actual starting address of the object program is not known until the load time. The relocation provides the efficient sharing of the machine with larger memory and when several independent programs are to be run together. It also supports the use of subroutine libraries efficiently. So, to avoid the possible assemblies of all subroutines when a single subroutine is changed and to perform the task of allocation and linking for the programmer, the general class of relocating loader was introduced. The output of relocating loader is the program and the information about all other programs it references. In addition, there is a information or the relocation information as to location in this program that must be changed if it is to be loaded in arbitrary location in memory. Now BSS, that means binary symbolic loader, it is the example of relocating loader. The BSS, that is binary symbolic loader, it allows many code segments but only one data segment. The output of the assembler using a BSS loader is object program, reference about other programs to be accessed and information about address sensitive entities. The relocation requirement of the program are influenced by addressing the structure of the computer system on which it is to execute. Many computer systems provide hardware support for relocation. The use of segment register reduces the relocation requirement of a program. Now let us consider a program segment, that is here offset is considered as 0 to 30, that is 30. So the address of variable x in the instruction address AREGX, it will be 30. If this program is loaded from memory location 500 for the execution, then the address of x in the in the instruction is it must be 5:30. Now the use of segment register make a program address insensitive. So all memory addressing is performed using displacement or offset. Starting memory address is stored in the segment register and the actual address is given by contents of the segment register plus address of the operand in the instruction. So the BSS, that is binary symbolic loader, it allows many code segments and one common data segment. The assembler assembles each code segment independently and passes on to the loader the following: object program prefixed by a transfer vector that consists of address containing names of subroutine referenced by the source program, the relocation information, that is the location in the program that must be changed if it is loaded in an arbitrary location in the main memory, the length of the source program and the length of the transfer vector. The loader loads the transfer vector and the object code into memory. Then the loader loads each subroutine identified in transfer vector. The transfer vector is used to solve the problem of linking, and the program length information is used to solve the problem of allocation. So this is all about the relocating loader. Now the next type is linking loaders or direct linking loaders. So it perform all linking and relocation at a load time. The other alternatives are linkage editors and dynamic linking. Linkage editors means which perform linking prior to the load time, and dynamic linking where linking function is performed at execution time. So this diagram shows the role of linking loaders. Here library, object program, linking loader and memory. So direct linking loader is a general relocatable loader, and it is perhaps the most popular loading scheme presently used. So it is a relocatable loader. And second point is it allows multiple procedure segment and multiple data segment. The assembler must give the loader the following information with each procedure or data segment. The first is length of the segment, and the second is a list of symbols defined in the current segment that may be referenced by other segments' public declaration. Third is a list of all symbols not defined in the segment but referenced in segment, that is external variable. Next is information about address constant and the machine code translation of source program and the relative address assigned. The object module produced by the assembler is divided into four sections, that is external symbol directory, actual assembled program, relocation directory and end of the object module. So what is external symbol? This is the object module produced by the assembler is divided into these four sections. So first section is external symbol directory. It consists of information about all the symbols that are defined in the program, but it may be referenced by other programs. It also contains symbols referenced in the program but defined in other program. So SD is symbol is a segment definition. LD means symbol is defined but it can be referenced by other program. ER is the external reference and it is defined in some external program. So the relative location of the program, that is main, is 0 and its size is 36. The symbol result is locally defined LD. LD means symbol is defined in the program but referenced by the other. And its relative address is 32. And the symbol sum is an external reference. The actual assessment program, the text portion of the object module contains the relocatable machine language instruction and data that were produced during the translation. Next is relocation directory. It contains one entry for each address that must be changed when the module is loaded into main memory. The relocation directory contains the following information, that is the address of each operand that needs to be changed due to relocation, by what it has to be changed, and the operation to be performed. And the next is end to object module, that is END. So this indicated the end of object module. So linkage editors, it produces a linked version of the program called a load module or an executable image. This load module is returned to a file or library for later execution. The linked program produced is suitable for the processing by a relocating loader. Using linkage editor, an absolute object program can be created if starting address is already known. So this diagram shows the role of linkage editor. Now the design of direct linking loader consists of, it is more complicated than that of the absolute loader. The input to the loader is a set of object program generated by the assembler or the compiler to be linked together. Each object module is divided into four sections. Each object module is divided into four sections. External symbol directory, EST, actual assembled program containing the binary code, that is TXT, relocation directory, RLD, and end of the object module, that is END. So a direct linking loader required two passes to complete the linking process, that is pass 1 and pass 2. Pass 1 means it assigns the address to all external symbols, and pass to it perform the actual loading, relocation and linking. So in pass 1, a global external symbol table, that is GEST, is prepared, and it contains every external symbol and the corresponding absolute address value. So, the global external symbol table, that is GEST, it contains every external symbol and its corresponding assigned memory address. Each SD, that is segment definition, and ER, that is external definition, it is given in a unique number by the assembler. So, this ID will be used in RLD. Now the format of database of a direct linking loader is, the major database in the design of direct linking loader are, first is the object records, that is object records are of the four types. These are ESD, TXT, RLD and END, it is already seen. So it is the input to the loader. Second is the global external symbol table, that is GEST. Third is local external symbol table LESA. Fourth is program local address PLA. And fifth one, initial program load address, that is IPLA. So the difference between a linkage editor and a linking loader is that linking loader perform all linking and relocation operations, including automatic library search, and loads the linked program into the memory for execution. And the linkage editor produces a linked version of the program, which is normally returned to a file or library for later execution. A simple relocating loader, that is one pass, can be used to load the program into memory for execution. The linkage editor performs relocation of all control sections relative to the start of the link program. The only object code modification necessary is the addition of an actual load address to a relative values within the program. The linking loader is suitable when a program is reassembled for nearly every execution. That is in a program development and testing environment. Also when program is used so infrequently, that is that it is not worthwhile to store the assembled and linked version. And the linkage editor is suitable when a program is to be executed many times without being reassembled, because resolution of external references and library searching are only performed once. So, this diagram shows the role of linkage editor, and this diagram shows the role of linking editor. This is one more difference between linking and linkage editor. Now, the linkage editor has a replacement of subroutine in the link program. There is a construction of the package for the subroutine generally used together. So, there are large number of cross references between these subroutines due to their closely related functions. The specification of external references not to be resolved by automatic library search. It can avoid a multiple storage of common libraries in program and need a linking loader to combine the common libraries at execution time. The linkage editor next is the dynamic linking. So this scheme postpones the linking functions until execution. A subroutine is loaded and linked to the rest of the program when it is first called. It is usually called dynamic linking or dynamic loading or load on call. It allows a several executing program to share one copy of subroutine or library. So there are some dynamic linking applications. It allows several executing programs to share one copy of subroutine or library. It allows the implementation of the shared object and its method to be determined at the execution time in an object-oriented system. Also, it provides the ability to load the routines only when they are needed, and this can result in substantial saving of the load time and memory space, for example, error handling routine. The implementation of dynamic linking consists of the subroutines to be dynamically loaded must be called via an operating system service request, for example, load and call, instead of executing a GSUB instruction. The service request will be handled by a part of the OS called dynamic loader, which is kept in memory during execution of the program. The parameter of this request is the symbolic name of the routine called. Also, in dynamic linking in an object-oriented system, the dynamic linking makes it possible for one object to be shared by several programs. Dynamic linking provides the ability to load the routine only when they are needed. Runtime linker uses a dynamic linking approach, which binds a dynamic executable and shared object at execution time. So the next part is implementation of MS-DOS linker. The MS-DOS compiler and assembler produce object modules. The object module is a sequence of object record. There are 14 types of object record. These record contain the following three basic categories of information, that is binary image, its machine instruction, external references and public definition. The name and the purpose of the object record type is, the first is record type THEADER, or we can say the header. So description is translator header, T header, we can say T header, translator header. Next is L names, that is list of names record. So next is segment definition, so SEGDEF is the record type. Next is external definition EXTDEF. Next is public definition PUBDEF. Translated instruction and data LE data. Next is fix up records for the relocation fix up module and record is MODENT. So the translator header, it records the specific name of the object module. The module end record, it records the marks, the end of the module, and it can contain a reference to the entry point of the program. Then LNAME, it records, it contains a list of all the segments. The EXTDEF, it records, it contains a list of external symbols that are used in the module. PUBDEF, that is public definition, it contains a list of symbols that is defined in a current module and it can be used by the other module. The LE data, that is it contains the binary image of the code generated by the assembler or the compiler. And fix up, it records, these are used to resolve references and to carry out addresses modification that are associated with relocation and grouping of the segment within the program. Now the data structure and algorithm. MS-DOS linker uses two passes for linking. So in pass one, object module are processed to collect the information about the segment and public definition and external definition. And in pass two, the relocation and linking are carried out. The linker invocation commands need the name of the object module to be linked, name of the executable file to be produced, and the load origin of the executable program. So in the first pass, the linker processes the object record for building external symbol director. And in the second pass, the linker constructs the executable program in work area. So data from LE data records is moved to appropriate part of the work area. The relocation and linking is performed using fixup record. And at the end of the processing, the output is stored in the executable file. So the algorithm for this second pass is that extract the module name from the command, repeat step for every object module, and select an object module and process its record. So the linkage editors perform the linking operation before the program is loaded for the execution. The linking loader performs the linking operation at the load time. The dynamic loading performs the linking operation linking at the execution time. To avoid the necessity of loading the entire library for each execution, that is, they load the routine only when they are needed. It allows the several executing programs to share one copy of subroutine or library. So the operating system service says that request of dynamic linking is dynamic loader is one part of the OS, and instead of executing JSUB instruction that refer to an external symbol, the program makes a load and call service request to the operating system. So this is all about the linkers and loaders.